There have been some dramatic twists and turns today in Tuesday's shooting attack at a Michigan high school. James and Jennifer Crumbly, parents of the accused 15-year-old killer, were charged with involuntary manslaughter this afternoon. Soon after, authorities in Oxford Township declared them fugitives and launched a manhunt. Still later, their attorney said they had left town for their own safety, but were returning to face arraignment. John Yang picks up the story from there.
Judy, the prosecutor, Karen McDonald, says the charges against the parents stem from what she calls egregious acts. She says the father bought the gun used in the shooting last week for his son. On the morning of the shooting, the parents were called to the school to talk about violent images their son had drawn.
James and Jennifer Crumbly were shown the drawing and were advised that they were required to get their son into counseling within 48 hours. Both James and Jennifer Crumbly failed to ask their son if he had his gun with him or where his gun was located, and failed to inspect his backpack for the presence of the gun, which he had with him. James and Jennifer Crumbly resisted the idea of then leaving the school at that time, of their son leaving the school at that time. Instead, James and Jennifer Crumbly left the high school without their son.
The prosecutor also said that the day before the shooting, a teacher reported that the accused shooter was searching for ammunition on his phone. Russ McNamara is the senior news editor for Detroit's NPR station WDET. Russ, thanks for joining us. What's the latest? As we've heard that there was a question of whether the parents were going to turn themselves in. Are officials confident that they are going to turn themselves in now?
Well, I'm not exactly sure at this point, because their attorney, Shannon Smith, says, yes, they left town shortly after the shooting for their own safety, and then we're going to make their way back for the arraignment. But the arraignment was supposed to be at 4 p.m. today. Oakland County Sheriff Mike Bouchard says the family is fleeing. The U.S. Marshals now, within the last hour, have said that they are now hunting for the couple as well as a fugitive task force here in the city of Detroit. So we still don't know where this family is.
And whether they're going to show up. We also learned a lot from that prosecutor's news conference today. For instance, there is evidence she described that suggests that this gun was a Christmas present for this young man.
Yeah, the child was there when the gun was purchased, and he essentially picked it out and his father purchased it for him. Teenagers cannot own a handgun here in the state of Michigan, and so it would be a gift. And the kid took it to the range and tried it out over the weekend with his mom.
And he also sort of showed it off on social media.
Yeah, he did that as well. And he was very active on social media. And that was part of the case that Karen McDonald laid out today against the parents, that this kid had a thing for guns, combined that with the violent imagery in the drawing and the fact that he was searching for ammunition in class, at school, all kinds of red flags along the way for both school officials and his parents. They should have known something was going on, I think.
Russ, tell us more about that drawing. We learned details of the drawing and also the parents' reaction when the school tried to reach out to them to tell them that they had found their son searching for ammunition in class.
Essentially, blood, stick figures, and help me in this drawing. And given the fact that he was just given a gun days before, the parents at that meeting on Tuesday morning saw no reason to take their kid out of school. The school recommended that the child seek psychiatric help within the next 48 hours. The family opted not to do that. And so the child there with the backpack in the room, the backpack was not searched. He goes back to class, and later the shooting happened.
And the day before, a teacher spotted him searching for ammunition on his phone. They reached out to the parents, and what happened or what didn't happen?
Well, the mom basically texted her son saying, LOL, I'm not mad, just don't get caught next time, which is, I don't know, kind of surprising to say the least, that given all of that information, the parents still decided to do nothing on Tuesday morning.
And Russ, as I understand it, the parents never responded to the school's calls or messages about this.
It wasn't until the second call that morning that they both went in and met with school officials and their son at the same time. And then after the shooting happened, both parents texted their son and told them not to do it. The father went home and then called 911 after he realized that the gun was missing.
Russ McNamara of NPR member station WDET in Detroit. Thank you very much.
Thank you, John.